Hey everyone, it's Keith from Amp Publishing. Today I'm going to review a cool piece of software called Amplifire. And before I get started on that, what you're looking at here is a dashboard for Wishloop. Now Wishloop is a basically an app or a business that has a suite of tools. Okay, so as you see here, there are four. These are actually four different tools. Depending on which you've purchased, those particular apps will then show up in your dashboard. Okay. So what I'm going to review today is Amplifire, which is basically the ability to grab the visitor's attention with full screen call to actions, okay, at the moment that they land on your page. And actually, there's a bunch of different settings on when you can display these particular opt-ins, okay? So before I get into it, though, I want to show you just a couple of uses for this before we actually get in and create one of these, and I'll show you how you can manipulate all the campaign settings, all right? So one way to use it is special offers, right? So if you have some sort of special, limited fashion collection, whatever it may be, you can pop in. All this is completely editable, by the way. These are just the templates that come with it. You can drop in timers, basically a buy now button that's going to then, of course, lead them to, to your particular offer. Now, you also have the ability to put up and deliver discount coupons, okay? So, for instance, this is a T-shirt, and if you want to, you can put again timers on it if you choose, and you press here to get it, and there it is, and then you can hit get it now, and it basically takes them over to wherever you want to lead them. Okay. Now, what you can also do is do kind of lead gen like contests and sweepstakes. All right. So there's a bunch of templates for those as well. This one happens to be for the pet niche. Do you have a dog? And we're offering free samples. Yes, I have a dog. It's going to take them to step two, which is basically you're going to collect their information, right? And you're going to enter their email address and do a sweepstakes to get a free pack of this particular dog food. Okay. Now, what they also have is what's called smart segmenting. And what you can do is really you can tailor the offer depending on how they answer a question. Okay. So for here, the growth hacks for newsletters, which are you interested in? Okay. So depending on which one they click on, you're going to lead them to a different second step, basically. So if I'm interested in conversion optimization, okay, now it just says conversion shifts. We're going to put whatever kind of text we want in here, and you're going to collect that email. So you can give them, there's a bunch of different ones, whether you're male, female, for kind of the dating niche. You can just basically tailor that second step to whichever they choose, okay? Now, you can also introduce new products. They have templates for that where you can plunk a video down in there and then check out a case study, which then you could lead them off into, wherever it is that you want to take them for that case study. And then, of course, we have the general just email opt-ins, okay? This one happens to be for weight loss. You can have, it's a two-step, okay? So a two-step process. And you sign up, download your free guide. You get the sign up, and then you go on your merry way. So these are just about five or six different examples of how you can use these and the templates to build these out really fairly quickly, okay? Okay, so what I'm going to do is jump back into the app, and I'm actually going to close out all these browsers, and we'll go back into here. Okay, so what we're going to do is we'll create, before we get into that, let's get into a little bit of the settings. I'll just show you that quickly. Now, there's integrations, of course. You can integrate with your autoresponders. I have mine with GetResponse here. You can also use the raw HTML, so really any autoresponder you want or you have, you can use as long as they give you that HTML code, which I think every one that I've ever seen, of the 50, 60, 70 that are out there, will give you that code. Or you can tap into the API if that integration is offered, okay? And here's this is who you can integrate with right now, okay? And then they have webinar platforms as well. All right, so let's go ahead and hop back over here to the installation. Okay, now installation. Now you don't have to have WordPress to use this, but it does come with a WordPress plugin. That's how I'm going to demonstrate this particular for this review. And it's a couple of easy steps. I'll actually show you that to you here. If we hop over to this, and then we see I have Wishloop installed here. And there's just a couple of settings, okay? So you're basically going to put an API, a user key, and then it'll basically grab all the pages that you get from, this one happens to be for Captfire, which is the second, the second application here that I'm going to show in a different video. But very simple to set up. You simply just upload that plugin and there it goes. Now you can also just use the universal, okay, which is you can put it into any website you want to. It doesn't have to be WordPress. You simply grab this code, put it into whatever pages that you want to. Now the suggested use, if you're going to do it on a straight HTML or dynamic website, is to include it in a some kind of a header file that would basically include it on all the pages of your website. But you certainly can just do it page by page as well, okay? Now, there's a couple of other integration points here that are used for the other applications. I'm going to skip those right now, and I'll review those in a different video, all right? So let's go ahead and let's just get into this here and create a new opt-in. So the first thing you're going to get is basically you're going to have 45 designs right now to start with, okay? So they've got them separated out. So you'll see there's a whole bunch of them in here. And I think we're just going to go with, the email collection here. We'll just go with this weight loss one. And I'm just going to go ahead and select it. That'll load. Okay, so now we're brought to a builder. Now, the one thing that I really like about their applications is they have a really nice guided tour that first time that you log in, and you can opt out of it too. You don't have to go through the entire thing, but they've done a great job of positioning tutorials and helpful hints as you go along, kind of your first time through a lot of the features. They do a great job of that. A lot of apps just don't. They do a miserable job of training you on how to use things, but this one does a really fantastic job. And I believe you can actually even launch that. I thought you could. Yeah, I think right here. Yeah, you can go ahead and check it out if you've already been through it. Okay. All right. So let's just take a look at some of the components here. So if you notice, I can select things and you'll see it starts to load over here on the right hand side. Each of these particular elements have different elements that you can edit, right? And you do that by simply just clicking on whichever one you're wanting to edit. Now, if you just click off of them, you can basically change the background. Okay, so here's the image, whether you want to display a scroll bar or not, and then some settings here, which is just basically the variation name, because you're actually allowed to, in the pro version, is you're able to do split testing. Okay, so you can apply weight to a few different variations of this and have them load depending on what those weights are. And I'll show you that as well. Again, that's in the pro edition. This is the front end version here that I'm showing you, okay? So they have many different components you can use, and basically if you just click on one, it gives you different options. So for media, you've got sound, your forms, you can do the built-in form. So basically I could drag this here if I wanted to. This one happens to be a two-stepper, so I would not want to do that here. But you can basically choose from a couple of different skins that it'll show you. You can choose which text fields you want to display, change the colors. Your settings, you can also do, again, this has all my lists loaded in it, so I can connect this right to my autoresponder. If I wanted to push to multiple lists, I can do that as well. And then really what to do after the submit, right? You can show a step, you can just do nothing and close it down, or redirect to a thank you page. And then put that URL in there, of course. And of course, it gives you some of the basic placeholder text that you can edit, input icons you can display or not, and so forth. So it's got a lot of nice little animations too that you can use as well for a lot of these elements, okay? Now I'm gonna go ahead and just delete this off of here. Let's take a look at what else we have. So we have social, we have like buttons, a like box, Google Plus, social buttons, Twitter. We have other click to call, other types of buttons that are already here. A PayPal button, so that's right there, already integrated in. Marketing, a bunch of different marketing. Here's a quiz, a Shopify widget, and Teespring countdown. Now I do want to be transparent. I believe the ebook and the computer screen and the quiz and the Shopify widget and the Teespring here are all part of the pro package, okay? I'm sorry, this is the pro package that I'm looking at, but that is part of the pro, not the front end offer, okay? You have geolocation, so you go by city name, country flag, all kinds of different areas there. Link to different steps, and I'll show you the steps here in a second. And there's a bunch of miscellaneous things in here, countdown timers, different layers, rulers, tracking codes, all kinds of other things you can add onto this opt-in, okay? Now here's your steps down here. So you can reorder these steps if you choose. So there's basically step number two, and then this is, I obviously want to ordered back here. Okay. So step number one, whichever you push on. Okay. So here's basically the order it's going to happen in, right? They're going to hit the first button. It's going to take them to step two. They're going to get the sign up, and then it's going to take them to download right here if you choose to do that. Because remember, you have the choice to either direct them off somewhere else after they submit the form or just close the opt-in altogether. All right, so they have a nice, easy undo, redo feature. This is a really actually kind of a cool thing here. They have a design previews. So this is basically what your preview is going to look like, and I'll go back to step one here. What the preview is going to look like on a desktop. This is on a tablet. Now, this is something I have not seen before, and I thought was a really cool feature. Is you can actually, it's a mobile builder. You can actually turn things off if you want to, because you know on mobile it can be a little. If you have a lot of things on the page, it can be get quite crowded or quite long. You can actually reorder these things, or just simply. Or reorder it like that, or just simply turn them off, okay? Now, you can do the same thing on for a mobile phone. All right, so it gives you a nice little view, and you can do your on-off, and you can switch the ordering there as well, okay? So I'm just going to go back into the edit mode. All right, so, you know, just taking a look at some of these things, double-clicking on text, very easy to use. It's pretty standard as far as any other builders that you've used. You're not going to see anything that much different. But it's cool here about, you know, how you can do these e-builder or the e-covers and changing the titles, get the image in there. So it's basically creating the cover image for you, which I believe is a pro feature. And of course, you have animations, which you could apply to just about any of these, just about any of the elements, okay? So that's basically how you create it. They make it very simple. The templates are awesome. I mean, I really got to say they've done a great job on the templates. And you can actually just load a template from here as well if you just want to switch it out on the fly. If you're not liking the one that you're using, you can go ahead and choose from any of these here as well and just go ahead and switch it out. All right. Okay, so once we're finished there, what I'm going to do is we're just going to save it. Okay, so things are successfully saved, and we'll go ahead and close this out, and then we'll get into the campaign settings. Okay, so campaign settings. Right here, we're just going to give it a name. I'm going to call it Demo 2. And you're going to check this to enable this. So basically, it will go live on your site once this is checked. So we don't have to do that right away if we want to go ahead and simply just get the settings correct first. Now you can give it a little description. This is internal to you if you want to. Your domain name. You're going to assign a domain to it, which domain you're on, because the licensings work where you can buy a single, a multiple, or an unlimited. So it will, depending on which plan you've purchased, you know, it will allow only so many domains. So I'm going to use this one here because that's the test site I'm using. And then my platform. Now you can actually choose it to be just mobile. If you're wanting optimization, opt-ins for just mobile use, or desktop only, or just all of them. For this purpose, I'll do for all. Okay, so now we can do display interval days. So if the user closed the pop-up or didn't take any action, we can set it for how many more days until they see it again, right? So if you have people revisiting, you know, we can set that to not show, especially if they're revisiting multiple times a day. It can get annoying, you know, to a user and kind of a turnoff to keep popping things up. So you can actually set that as well. And they have what's a persistent, a closable, and a locker. And I'll actually come back to this and show you exactly what those three things do once we get it onto the site, okay? Now, you can delay in seconds as well. I would suggest delaying no longer than 20 seconds because that's about how much time you're going to have to capture somebody's attention anyways. So you can set that delay here. You can also have it slide down, none, or fade in, okay? And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to check is where to show these. So what you can do is you can show on all pages, or you can exclude some pages. Okay, so as long as you follow this formatting here, you can actually copy in the URLs that you just want to exclude. So if you have the code in your site and it's set for all your pages, you can actually just eliminate or exclude as many as you'd like. vice versa, you can do the same thing to show on all pages. So you can specifically choose which pages just to show it on only. Okay, so the reason that they would do it that way is if I only have five pages on my entire website, but I want to show it on three, this might be the easiest way for me to do it. If I have 500 pages on a site, I definitely would, but I want to show it on the majority of them, and maybe I don't want to show it on five or six of them, I would just go ahead and use this particular to exclude just those few pages and show on the other 480 pages, okay? All right, so the next one here is, so this one is for retargeting. Now, this is an upgrade feature. This is basically how Wishloop works is, if you have one of the applications, or if you have all four of the applications, you can pay a monthly fee. I think it's $9.99 a month or something like that, to unlock targeting and triggers for every application that you have. Okay, and what this is going to allow you to do is who should see these pop-ups. Okay, so you can get whether it's a return visitor, you can actually tailor the message to them. So if it tracks by IP address basically. So if it notices that somebody from the same IP already opted in, you may want to show them a different opt-in, right? You don't want to keep pestering with the same opt-in because they've already signed up. So you can basically, it unlocks a bunch of features and settings for you to be more segmented in what you're showing and who you're showing it to, okay? So for right now, I'm going to go ahead and just save this, and I'm going to keep a persistent on here and just show you what the difference between some of these, what these look like, okay? Okay, so I'm going to want to actually check that as well to make sure that it's set. Save that. Okay. All right. So if I go here. Okay. So there it is. It scrolls down. This is going to work the same way as I showed you before. So I'm clicking that. I'm going to opt in here, put my information in, and it's going to take me to that download page or whatever I've told it to do after the submission, right? So now what happens, that is persistent. When I scroll down, this is the actual site. I apologize that it looks terrible. It's just a test site. But you can see it's now persistent. It's there, okay? So it's always going to stick to the top of the browser when they scroll all the way back up. Now, if I switch it over to closable, then what we'll do is save that. Okay, reload. All right, and I have it set for that 1 second delay, and there it is. Now what happens is when I get to a certain point, like up there, it's closed, okay? Notice I can't get back up there. It's only gonna show it that one time, okay? Now there's also I believe the other one is locker. And let's see here, let me go down here and save it. There we go. Okay. Now this one, you can't do anything. You would have locked them in, okay? I find that would irritate me if I were to go to websites that do that, but there are definitely purposes for something like this. I think where you might find it is if you're locking content and you've maybe showed them 20 seconds, 30 seconds of content that they're allowed to look at, but then this is going to drop down and say, hey, look, if you want to access this fantastic content, join up and sign up for my membership site. And so it's forcing them to have to actually pay for the rest of the views. There are some actually large news outlets out there that use this type of feature. So there is definitely features to lock content. So this is exactly what you'd use that for. Okay, so let's go ahead and get back to the dashboard here. Actually, I want to get to manage here. Okay, so now I'm on demo 2 here. We'll take a look at, so basically this is what your dashboard would look like after you start creating some campaigns, okay? You could duplicate them, delete them, edit the settings, you can view, and you know, you can check out your leads as well. Now, of course, I don't have any leads because I didn't do anything yet, but you can learn right here how to collect leads. It will basically show you a nice tutorial on how to do that. And then if I click the demo 2, what it's gonna show me now is again the ability that it's enabled, the ability to edit the campaign settings. It's going to give me some impressions and conversions. Now this is approximately every 10 minutes, so it's not going to load every one of them that we've just clicked on, but you'll see some of them are starting to load already. So you can filter down and check those out. You can get your conversions, your conversion rates, the impressions. And now with the pro version, here's where the variation comes in, okay? So if I hit new variation, it's basically gonna walk me through the same steps that we just did. And I would go ahead and choose, you know, something else. I'll just select one for the sake of demonstration here. And then what I'll do is just save it real quick. Okay, and we'll close out of that. And now you'll see I have two variations that are going to load on this site, right? And you could even really clone one of these and maybe just change the heading or the messaging. You might want to leave the background the same, but just see if a certain message converts a little bit better. But you can also give it the traffic weight. You know, how much weight are you going to put towards this? So right here, it's just half and half. Half my traffic is going to go to variation one. Half of it's going to go to variation number two. So that basically concludes Amplifire. Very cool. They did a fantastic job of building the software. They make it so easy to use in the admin area. I look at a lot of software, believe me, a lot of software before I really, and I really will only review things that I feel are worthy and are going to give value to my viewers. This is very, very cool. They did a fantastic job. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to put a link down in the description. You can go ahead and click on that to learn a little bit more information if you'd like, or go ahead and get your copy. I'm also going to, like I said, do three more reviews for each of these other applications and show you kind of how those work as well. Because when you have the whole suite, you can use some of these applications together, which makes it pretty powerful. Now, if you want to be notified when I put those up, and I'm hoping in the next week or two, I'll have all four of them done. All three of the other ones done. Just simply subscribe and make sure your notifications are on, and you'll be notified when I upload that particular review. All right, well, thanks for joining me, and go ahead and pick up your version of Amplifire.